evaluate each project.
Augustine Tamale, the entity's chief finance officer, made this appeal during an interaction with the Information, Communication and Technology Committee chaired by the Budiope East MP Moses Magogu. According to Tamale, the aforementioned money is for the resumption of a string of local newspapers that folded during the COVID-19 pandemic.
Next year will be much better, being that the economy is now improving significantly.
In the 2022-2023 financial year budget, Parliament appropriated 2.9 billion shillings to the Vision Group to revive regional newspapers, including Orumuri for Western Uganda, Etop for Eastern, and Rupini for Northern Uganda. But to date, Vision Group is yet to receive any release from the Ministry of Finance.
The appropriation was 2.9 billion Uganda shillings. Those papers were closed during the pandemic because they were making losses. However, to date, we are yet to receive that release because of some cash controls at Ministry of Finance. So we have not yet received that money, and we are into the fourth quarter. So that is the only thing that is missing from us.
And you remember, it was a bit of a tug of war for us to get this money, but also it hasn't been released.
The Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Waliomunsi, hinted that the decision to grant New Vision 2.9 billion shillings followed concerns by President Yoweri Museveni.
The budget was coming at 2.9. We did all we could, but finance up to now has not released the resources. And actually the people in those communities want these papers back on the streets because we pass on information through those vernacular papers. So
Tamale explained that these papers were closed during the pandemic because they were making losses due to COVID-19 induced restrictions. They are credited with preserving native tongues, strengthening communities by focusing on localized news events, which include but not limited to regional politics, business and human interest stories.
If a particular operation doesn't make money, it is shut down. Now, of course, our colleagues at UBC have done several things that may not generate income. For us, we evaluate each project on its commercial viability before we undertake it.
As they wait for the release of these funds, Tamale disclosed that the company is in the midst of establishing Radio Kabalega that will serve Runyoro Rutoro speakers. This will bring the number of radio stations to 7.
Coming year, we have a construction at Namanve of a factory ongoing, and we are also going to open up a radio station. We didn't have a footprint in Bunyoro. We are going to open up Radio Kabalega.
Does it solve our problem in Ichibali? You remember the issues we're having? We know UBC is trying to do something as well, but does this solve the problem? I don't know its coverage. Wherever you are, where are you centering it?
New Vision Printing and Publishing Company Limited is majorly owned by the government with 53.3% of its shares, while other shares are held by the public. After witnessing a dip in sales during the COVID-19 pandemic, Augustine Tamale says they are back to profitability and have already amassed 240 million shillings as the half-year profit. This figure is expected to be doubled by the end of this ongoing financial year.
And our half-year results had a moderate profit of 240 million shillings. We expect to more than double that by the time we close this financial year in June.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.